Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be mixing it up from the clothes and upcycling some chairs.
Okay, so something just happened. My memory card was full. I tried to delete some stuff from my camera and I deleted all my footage. So you can't see how I just made this amazing chair. You know, it is what it is. We're not gonna let it get us down. Set. Oh, I can't believe I deleted everything. So, as you can see, today is another day. It's actually the next day. I had to give myself a bit of time after I deleted all of my footage, literally everything I've ever taken on my camera. So that was difficult. So I needed sort of like a day to get over it, and now I'm back, I'm ready to film how to do the other three chairs. So the only good thing about what's happened today is that now I can say welcome. This is the chair that we're going to transform, and here's one I did earlier. Ta-da! I love this. I've been so obsessed with seeing these Bouclé, I think that's how you say it, Bouclé chairs on Instagram, on just everywhere on the internet pretty much. All the influencers seem to have this like sheeling fabric stuff going on. And I really wanted to get some pieces for my home, but, well, for our home. But we're not decorating yet and we just can't justify spending like £200 on a sofa or a chair that, you know, we don't know if it will go with the final decor, although I think it would. But anyway, I needed to upcycle these chairs that we got from Jordan's grandparents, and so let's get to it. The footage that I filmed yesterday, I had a bit of trial and error, and in the end I didn't end up taking this off. I just put the fabric over the top. So this fabric I got online off Amazon. It was about £10 a metre. I got 3 metres and it's 150 width, so I'm hoping that there'll be a little bit left over so I can make something either faux fur collar or some kind of little jacket maybe. The hardest part is actually detaching the seat from the frame, because you have to unscrew it, and you know, I'm not the most DIY person when it comes to using tools, so it did kind of hurt my hands. But we'll see. We managed to do one, so we can probably do the next one. So first thing I'm going to do is unscrew the seat from the chair. So there are 4 screws at the back. Oops. So I gave the underneath of the chair a bit of a hoover because there were a few little cobwebs. And then I got to unscrewing it, and these were actually in really tight, so it was quite hard, but I just went round and tried to loosen them all up a little bit so that it makes it easier to take it all out together. Okay. So the back of the seat has loads of pins in it, and I worked out yesterday that it's just too much hassle to take the pins out, and I was better off just putting the new fabric over the top. So you get your fabric.
This part was quite straightforward. I put the seat over the fabric and cut around it, leaving enough so that it can fold round nicely. I used my pins and my functioning hammer pliers to just hammer in some of the pins, and making sure that the fabric was on nice and tight. I had the stretch going across the width of the seat, and that made it fit on quite nicely. I worked on the corners, folding it over, making sure that when the seat is back on the frame of the chair, you can't see any of the blue over the side, and just try to make it as neat and tight as possible, and hopefully it will stay relatively well. And then any excess bits, like the bit that you can see there, I trimmed off.
I just love it, it looks amazing. It makes me so happy. Okay, so the final part of the chair process is to get the four screws that we had earlier, and then we just pop them underneath to make sure that this chair is secure. And you'll need your flat screwdriver again. Two down, two to go. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed. Okay, I'm gonna end the video here. Thank you for watching. I've run out of pins, so I can't finish the final chair, but we have three that are done. Show you quickly. Three. That one still needs some pins. So that's my Bouclé inspired DIY chairs. I hope you enjoyed. And if you try it out, let me know. If you made it to the end of the video and you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. That would make me very happy. And yeah, like, comment, let me know what you think. And yeah, I do feel like already it's made the room look so much brighter, which is really nice.